Okay. Good morning, all. I'm audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So, in last lecture, we are seeing the concept that is a regular expression. We will see the different operations on the regular expression. So, today we will start with the next point that is a basic date and time means now we are representing the or seeing the date and time. The date and time will be having some specific format like DD. The date means what we consider as a DD, MM, YY, and time will be like in a verse like that. All different ways are there. Okay. So the Python date and time are not a data type of their own, but a module named date time can be imported to work with the data as well as time. Means what we are having the like we are importing like import RE module for like a regular expression. So for same for the date and time we are having the a module that is a date time. Okay. So in Python date time module comes to means it is a built-in function. The date time module is a built-in function. Okay. So Python date time modules supplies class to work with the date and time. Means what? If we are importing the date and time module in our program, so it will be directly moved to the functions that we are using in that module. Means like a date function is having some different type of operations, or the representation of date will be a different like that. Same for a time also. The class provide a number of functions deals with the date and time. Okay, time interval means like suppose we want to some in you know that if suppose you have to fill some of the forms or details like that, in that some way sometimes they have to mention that you have to enter year first, then date, and then month like that. Somewhere date, month like that means we are having the different representation related to time also and related to date also. Okay, so first we will see the date. So normally we consider as a date class. So in that we are representing the date in the format of year, month, and date. Okay, year, month, and date. And in that, suppose we are creating the objects. So for date class, we are having different operations. So we will see the operation. My programming screen is visible to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here you have to see here. The object representing the data in date in Python means what? Here I am, first of all, I am importing the date time. From date time. Why? Because I want to, just 1 minute. Okay. You have to see here. Here I am, date and type is a built-in module in Python. So I want to access only date. So for that, I should represent from date and time module, I will import the only date. Okay. For time, we are representing here time. So my date is equal to date of here. I am representing in the format of year, month, and date. Okay, and just I want to display the date. So you have to see here the output. You have to see the representation of output will be in the format of date. Here you have to see here at the declaration, I am not giving any symbol like dash. You have to see here the output. So it will be the dash automatically. It will be accessible. Why? Because we are importing the module here, date module. It will be already built in module. Okay. So this example will be simply a representation of a date. Okay. Next will be suppose we want to the current date. Means the today's date. What is today's date? So for that, simply same module, the representation will be same. Just I am calling the method that is today. date dot today means the today's date will be a display. So you have to see here the output 29/12/2021. Okay, and it will be the representation of current date. Means how to find the current date? So for that we are having today's today function. Okay, that is date dot today. So it will be the represent this method to the current date. Okay. Okay, all of you understood how to display the current date?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Ma'am.
Okay, so all of you do this to program. One is simply a representation of date, other is a how to display the current date, present date. Okay. Next will be the we want to give the specific format, that is, you know, that year, month and date format. So we want to display the date like current year, current month and current date wise, means same. You have to see here the representation, like current means current. I want to display the current data. Same, just representation will be different, but I am using the method today's year, today's month and today's date here. Okay, so it will be just other representation. Okay, so it will be the other type of representation of displaying the current date. Next will be the get the date from the time span. Time span means what? Some specific duration. I want to take the time. Okay, so for that I am using declaring one of the variable, that is date time is equal to date time dot from time span. Time span means what? It will be a specific time that will be we want to display here. Like here I am mentioning some random number actually here. So I want to display that time span. So you have to see here the difference. Means what? It will be displaying the date like 25/10/2029 actually, and the time means what? It will be a time span. Means we want to find the date of some means किती तरी वर्षानंतरची आपल्याला डेट हवी आहे. तर simply we are using the method that is from time span. Means like आपण म्हणू शकतो भविष्य काळातली गोष्ट. Here आता मी इथं काय करते, मी नंबर इथं बदलते. Suppose मी इथं 19 करते. So you have to see here the difference, that is date will be changed and time also will be a change. Means here I am giving randomly time span number. It will be the number that or the value that we want to give for that time span. It will be a 10-digit number. Okay, so it will be a displaying the number in the means what? The value or time of a future. Okay, so it will be a other way. Then next will be a convert date to string. Means what? We want to means as date means what? It will be a, like a number, one of the number. So we want to suppose convert that number into the string format. For that we are firstly displaying the one of the variable, that is today is equal to date dot today, and for converting that date into a string, I am using ISO format. ISO format means what? Input string output formatting. Input string output formatting, and just I am calling that variable name here, and I am converting that string that date into the string format. You have to see here the representation. The string representing that this will be a today's date, and the data type of this string this date will be the string. Okay, Why? Because here we are converting that the date in the a string format by using ISO format method. Okay, so it will be the other way to represent the date and date. Okay, so we are having five total operations on the date. That is, first one will be a simple representation of date. Then we are performing remaining all operations related to current date or future date. Okay. So all of you do the program. Any doubt is there regarding date? How to represent any means a date or any point which you want to repeat? Okay, now we will move to the next point. You have to perform the program and you have to share on the group. We will move to the next point, that is a time class. Okay, the time class creates a time object which represents a local time independently on any day. Means what? Same like date, we are performing on the future or present like that. Okay, so we are moving to the towards the program. So just 1 minute. Okay, now we will move to the next point, that is a time class. Okay, so first the object representing the time in Python means, or it will be the simply representation of time, means here we are using the same module, that is import time. Okay, here we are using import time module from date time function. Date time built-in function is what? Date time. From that we are collecting the only time module. Okay, here I am just representing the time in the simply like a 13, 24 and 56. It will be the like hours, minute, like that clock. Okay, so here simply I am printing the date that I will display here, this values. Okay, and after that what I will give, I will give use the same variable name, and I am using the time dot minute is equal to 12. Means what? Minute is equal to 12. I am representing for the minute, means how much for calculation we required the this a minute value here. And after that I am, what I should do, I should pass the one of the argument, and I am want to call the this the function, that is time function. Here you have to see here the representation. First means what? 13, 24 and 56, it will be a represent the time. And after that you have to see here, here I am passing the minute, that is 12 minutes. Means what? The representation of one argument, that is it will be a represent minute in the form, in the only, means I am fixing the minute value, that is 12. It will be a represent here, and without argument means what? Here I am not passing any argument, so it will be represent the format of day, time will be a 00:00:00. Okay, so simply here suppose we will change the values, it will be represent in the format of like this. Okay, simply for like the date, it will be represent the time. Okay, now next will be we want to get the date, time and a second or microsecond in the format of like one by one, like the date, the time we will provide in the our program at variable declaration, that will be in the form of like hours, minutes, second and a microsecond. So you have to see here the output. Here microsecond will be a zero. Why? Because we are not providing any value here, so that's why it will be represent the zero. Suppose here I am passing 34, so it will be represent like 11 hours, 34 minutes, 56 second and 34 microsecond. Okay, so like same date we are representing this also in the one more format. After that you have to see here the convert the time object into a string, means same like a date we are converting time time into a string format. So here simply I am taking the time with the four attributes like hours, second, minute, seconds and microsecond. And after that same ISO format, means ISO format is what? Input string, output, means we are converting the variable that present here, that is this time variable, in the string format. And here we are displaying the type of that a string that we want to display. Okay, so it will be a represent this string as in the string format. After that we want to we want the suppose current date and time, means we will this module means what? We are displaying the both the time and date, current time and date. So for that we are which module we are importing? We are importing a date time module. Okay, and just for current date and time we are using the method that is now, means current, the now method for the current displaying of current date and time. Okay, so it will be the different operation that we are performing on the performing on the date and time mode. So if we want the current date and means current present time. So for that we are using the now function. Means you have to see here the output. It will be displaying 4.27, 5.80, like means it will be the microsecond. So it will be a displaying wrong time. Why? Because the system time will be a different here. Actually, you have to see here the system time 8:23. So that's why it will be a displaying the a different time. So all of you understood the time the operation which we want to perform on the a time class, that will be a same like a date classes. We are performing the three operations on the time. So any doubt is there regarding a time class?
हेलो मैम,
हाँ यस,
कैन वे डिस्प्ले ऑन डे करंट टाइम विदाउट डेट?
विदाउट डेट, हाँ, फॉर दैट फॉर करंट टाइम वी आर यूजिंग द सेम हियर दिस फंक्शन लाइक मींस करंट डेट डेट और टाइम
टाइम
टाइम या जस्ट वी आर हियर Just one minute. This type of date time is not in my computer. Current time. Just a moment today, the current time today. So we are using this way just for only displaying the current time. Actually, you have to perform on the your system. It will be a display the current time. Actually, this system timing will be a different. So that's why it will be give the other time. So for displaying current timing, we are using the method that is strftime. Means what? We are representing a current time now. Means we directly now method only if we call this now method like this, it will be not work for the displaying current time. So for that, we are calling the now method by using string ftime function. Means we are displaying the current time in the format of hours, minutes, and seconds. So we are having this method now dot strf time. Okay, you have to perform this operation on your system. So I think so you your system will be give you a correct date. Actually, my timing will be a different. So that's why it will be a represent other timing. So you have to perform this operation. Okay, any doubt is there?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so you have to perform this operation for displaying current timing by using now method.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, yes.
It's working.
Okay, now we will move to the next point, that is a general calendar related function. Like a date time, we are having one more inbuilt model, that is calendar model. So Python defines an inbuilt model calendar that handles operation related to the calendar. Means what we are we are importing date time like that. We are importing calendar model to perform the various operation related to the calendar. Okay, the calendar module allow output calendars like the program and provide the additional useful function related to the calendar. Means what we are performing like different operations on calendar also, like we are performing like representation of date and time like that. We are performing different additional operation of functions we are using for performing the operation on the calendar. So the function and classes defines the calendar module, use and initialize the calendar. The current calendar extended infinitely in the both the directions. Okay, means what we are using the function and class for declaring the calendar module, and we are performing the operation on the current the year of current year of that calendar or current month of that calendar. Okay. So by default, the calendar having suppose Monday as a first day on the week and Sunday as the last day, it will be the European conversation. Means what we all are following that, like Monday is the first day of our week and the Sunday is the last day of our week. So it will be the European conversation. Okay, so the operation we all are performing on the calendar is of calendar. First you have to see here the parameter, that is year, a week, leap year or a okay, so this function display the year, the width of the character, width of the character, number of the lines per week and the column. Means what the representation of column means what you have to see here the this means this line means you have to see here the date which we want to select. It will be the providing the box like that. So the simply displaying this structure, for that we are having the year, width of that character means this 28, it will be having some length for drawing this box. So and how many lines, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 line are there. Why? Because we are having 7 days, okay, in the week. And after that we are separating the column like this. For Sunday, all Sunday we are having one column, for all Monday we are having one column like that. So simply we will see the example for that. Okay, first for simply displaying the calendar for the given month, means what we have to provide here. We are importing first calendar module, in that we are providing the year and month. And after execution, you have to see here, it will be display the calendar of current month. Suppose here I am changing the month. So it will be a display the calendar of that month. Means it will be a display the calendar of 11, month 11. Okay. So simply it will be, we are using here a month module, that we are providing the year and the month which we want to provide here. So it will be the simply representation. Means what, we are using this module to display the, just simply we are providing here the parameters, that year or that month calendar will be a display. Suppose here I am providing 2022. So it will be display the calendar of that month, the future month, that is in the year of 2022. Okay, so it will be the simply representation of the calendar. Next, we are having operation, that is the next operation will be the first weekday means this function return the first weekday number. First weekday number by default zero means Monday. Means what this function, the first weekday means what we know that the first day of our week will be a Monday. So it will be by default at this location. Why? Because Sunday is the first. But as per the rule, that the European conversation rule, we are starting our week with the Monday and end with the Sunday, like that. Okay, next is the is leap year, means what this function checks if you are mentioned in the argument is the leap or not. Like we are performing the leap year, means what? Can anyone tell what is leap year?
Divisible by 4.
Yes, so that will be the leap year. So just we are providing the arguments in our program, so the it will be written that the entered the value means entered the calendar date. Like suppose I am entering today's date, so it will be a leap year. This year will be a leap year.
No ma'am,
no, this will be a not leap year. Okay, so it will be a represent it if the year that we want to enter in the our program, that will be a leap, it will be written, it will be a leap year. Otherwise it will be a display, it is a not leap year. Then next, leap year, suppose we are providing some range, like suppose here I am providing 2021 and here I am providing 2025. So this function will be find the argument that we are passing here in between that year, is any year is a leap year, like that. And next will be a month. In that we are having year, month, width, and the lines. Means this function print the month of the specific year mentioned. It will be a print the specific year, year calendar or month calendar, and with the argument that we are passing that month, means which month, which year, and how much characters are there. So here after that you have. Suppose we want to display the calendar of the given year, means here I am passing the argument that is 2021, then width 2, you have to see here, it will be display the calendar of all, means here I am passing like the value start with the 1, like that. All the argument means here I am, suppose here I pass the 2022. So you have to see here, it will be display the time, display the calendar of 2022. Here whole calendar will be a display. Okay. So if here this method, we are using calendar.calendar and we are passing the argument here for displaying the calendar of year that we want. Suppose here I am entering ...1996. So you have to see here, it will be display the calendar of 1996. Okay. Next, we are seeing the four to five methods here. Means first is the first week's day, means that method. So for that first, we are importing the calendar module. After that, we want to print the, suppose here I am writing here, I want to display the calendar of 2012. Here I am using the method that calendar.calendar that we are using here previously to display the all the month which is present in that year. And after that, what I should do, I will here use the print calendar dot first. So it will be a display. The calendar dot first week means what? It will be a display that year of that year calendar. After that, the width of that character means the representation, like this 1, 2, 3, 4, this all representation. And after that, we are having lines and the columns, which will be separated with the days. Okay. So you have to see here, it will be display the all the calendar, and you have to see here the starting date number is a calendar is a zero. It will be just simply method here, end with. So this method means first week, week's day means what? First week day is, you know that start with the one. The first week day will start with the one, that we know that all. So the simply first week means what? First week day means what? The first week day will be the Monday. Means not Monday, but it starts the fixed date with the one value. It will be the first weekday function. The next will be is leap or is leap day. For that we are writing a same program. Just we are here mentioning is leap year, means here I am putting the 2021, but we know that it will be a not leap year. And so for that we are using the if else. So for comparing the year, if that year, the entered year is a leap year, it will be display the method of print. Otherwise it will be a display the method in the part which is present in the else. Okay, so you have to see here the is not leap year. Why? Because here we are mentioning 2021, so it will be a not leap year. And for leap days, here I am providing the 2 years, range of 2 years, like 1915 to 2021. So in this function you have to see here total 18 means the year 1950 to 2021, total 18 years are the leap years. Sorry, leap days. 18 total leap days are 20. From the 1950 to 2020 is 8. If you want to perform this operation in mathematics, so you need to calculate by using some of the formulas to find that the 1915 to 2021 how many leap days are there. So just here we are using a simple function, that is leap days function. Here we are providing the range of years, and we are displaying the leap days. And last will be a month function, that we are seeing here that we are having 4 arguments here. So in that, just simply we are providing the first year, then month, and the this function will be month function will be a same like this calendar function. First function, it will be a find the width of the character and the number of lines that we want to take for that year. Suppose here I change a 3 and here I will put 1. So you have to see here the difference. If here I increase the value, so you have to see here the representation means what? If you are changing the value, these 3 values, like the month value, the width and the number of line value, so it will be a represent the different representation. Suppose here I will mention 9 and here I will mention 5. So you have to see here the difference. It will be a provide the width with the 9, that value I pass here, that is 9 for the width, and the number of line 5. You have to see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lines in this, means at start it will be start with the 5 lines. Okay, so it will be a simply a representation of the month function. Okay, so these 4 are the operations that we are performing on the calendar. Okay, so any doubt is there regarding this of five operations, that is calendar, first weekday, and is leap year or not, or leap days and month? The all operation will be related to each other actually. Just simply the representation or the parameter which we want to pass here, it will be a different. Okay, so any doubt is there regarding calendar point? It will be a same like we are using the operation in date time, like that same all operations or functions are there.
मैम लीप डे चेक दाखव.
व्हाट
लीप डे च
इन लीप डे वी आर परफॉर्मिंग टू ऑपरेशन्स. वन इज टू मीन्स फाइंड दैट द इयर दैट वी आर मेंशनिंग इन अवर मीन्स हियर इन द आर्ग्युमेंट. That will be a leap or not, and other will be the we are passing some range of years. Like you have to see here, 1950 to 2021. How many leap days are there? So you have to see here, 2021 is not leap year. Can anyone tell any leap year?
2024.
Okay. So you have to see here. The year is a leap year. Okay, so we are using is leap year function to find that the year that we are mentioned here, that will be a leap or not, and other will be we are providing the range here. Total 18 days are there that will be a leap year in this range, that is 1950 to 2021. Okay, so we will move to the next point, that is container data type. So the container are any object that hold an arbitrary number of object. Generally, container provides the way to access the container objects can is to be iterate over them. For example, the container data type means what? List, tuple, set, and dictionary. Container data type means what? List, tuple, set, and dictionary. So the other data that means we are accessing data in the list, tuple, set, and dictionary in the different ways. Like we are performing some of the operations on that. Like we are updating the values of list, list, set, and dictionary. We are not means the list, set, and dictionary is the mutable and tuple is a immutable. Means we can't change the value in the tuple, but we are changing the values of set, dictionary, and tuple. That all this the container data type point already covered in the second chapter. that is the container data type means what? List, tuple, set and dictionary. Okay. So next, we are having NumPy. So NumPy is a standard for a numerical Python, which is a Python package for the computation and processing of the multidimensional and the single dimensional array elements. Means what? NumPy is a one of the module that will be a totally numerical module. NumPy is a totally numerical module. Many of you are using this package, NumPy package. So it will be a numerical. It provides the high performance multidimensional array object and tools for working with this array. Means we are using this NumPy to work with the array functions, most of the, and creating of objects to different tools which we are using to display the variables, functions and classes. It provides various functions which are compatible of performing the numerical computations with the high speed. Means what? We are using the mathematics function, many of the mathematics functions in our program. So that time we are, most of the time we are importing this NumPy module, and it will be a execution of program. Suppose we want to find the suppose the we are providing the one of the list here, and we want to find that largest number program or smallest number program. So for that we are suppose using the min max function. So that time we are displaying that NumPy module to find if we are using that min and max function. So that time the NumPy module will be return the output quickly. So NumPy provides various powerful data structures implementing the multidimensional array and matrix. So most of the time if we want to perform the addition of matrix or array, that time we are it will be the it will be the very powerful tool. Why? Because means in array we are having values more than more than once, and in matrix we are having one of the different representation. Matrix means what? We are representing values in the row and the column format. So for addition of that, suppose we want to perform the addition of two matrix, so we are using that function. These data structures are used for the optimal computations regarding arrays and matrix. Means what? Totally we are using this all operation in the depend on the arrays and matrix. Okay, so array in NumPy means what? NumPy main object is the homogeneous multidimensional array. It is a table of elements, usually numbers, all of the same type, indexing by a tuple of a positive integer. Okay, so array means what? It will be a table of elements, or all the data type, the means the table of that element which we are entering number, that will be a same data type. So we are not like in array we are not displaying like it one is a integer object, variable is integer, or there is a string like that. We are displaying array in the format of table, and that will be all will be the same data type. In NumPy, dimensions are called axis. Means axis, you know that y-axis and x-axis. So we are presenting that axis is a rank, or like we are using the range function. So like that, we are called it as that axis will be a rank. The number NumPy array class is called the ND array. NumPy array means we are using the NumPy array. So for that we are calling it as a ND array. It is also known by the Alice array. It is also known as a Alice array. Means ND array is also known as what? Alice array. Okay. So the how we have to create the array. So we are having two ways. One is a array indexing, and other one is a array indexing. And other is we are performing the different operations. So array indexing means what? Knowing the basic of array indexing is important for analyzing the manipulation of the array objects. Okay, indexing function means what? We know that suppose we are providing a of I is equal to 0 means what? It will be point to the zeroth location of that array. We are like that. We are performing different operation on the indexing means we are suppose we are giving the we are performing the slicing operation on that array. That time we are providing the values start location to the end location. Like we are giving the range and also we are performing the negative slicing operation. Also there we are providing just a negative value there to perform the operation. Okay, so here you have to see here. Right now I am explaining that slicing operation on the array. And then next is the integer array index. Means what? In this method, lists are passed for the indexing for each dimension. One-to-one mapping of the corresponding element is done to construct a new arbitrary array. Means what? Here simply indexing array means what? Suppose we are having two arrays, and in that each and every value or element which will be a means the addition operation will be performed, and one more new array will be generated. After performing the operation, it will be a display one more new array. Then Boolean array indexing. This method is used to when we want to pick element from array which satisfy some conditions. Means what? Boolean means what? We know that the Boolean function is having only two values, that is one is true and one is false. So if our condition will be satisfied, it will give some results. Otherwise it will be a not giving any result. It will be display some method, it will be a invalid, like that. So we will see here the program. Here, first array in NumPy means how we are representing array in NumPy. So for that, you have to see here. First, here I am using importing NumPy. Why? Because this all operation that we are performing here, it will be related to NumPy model. So NumPy as a NP. Here NP means we are giving any name as you have to give your any name. It is not compulsory that you have to provide NP only here, but you have to write the name which is represent here, that will be we are using in our program. Okay, so here I am creating a two array. Here you have to see first array array is equal to NP dot array of 1, 2, 3, and other array will be 4 to 5. Okay, any value that you want to represent or put in our array. After that, this line will be the I want to find the element that I am entering in my array, which will be a which data type. For that, I am just writing this line. After that, here dimension means for access. How many access are there, that will be provided by using number of dimension is equal to array dot n dimension. N dimension is a method that will be find the axis, how many axes are there in your array. After that means a shape of array means which way, like the representation of array means I want the first display this array, after that I want display this array, like one by one means the proper representation. So for that we are using the shape method to display the or represent the array. After that, total number of element, how many elements present in our array. So for that we are using the size function, array dot size. It will be display the number of element which is present in our array. And after that I will find the data type of array that will be a newly generated. So you have to see here in the first I will find that the data type of my array. It will be a nd array. Why? Because it will be a related to numpy, so it will be called it as a num nd array. After that, the number of dimension here, two dimension are there. Why? Because the 1, 2, 3 will be a one array and other array will be a 4 to 5. So it will be written that 2. And after that, the shape of array will be a 2 into 3. Why? Because it will be having a 2 column and 3 rows are there. After that, size of array will be 6. Why? Because we are having 6 element, totally 6 element in the array. So it will be a represent that the size of array will be 6. Array store the element is in the integer 64. Integer 64 means what? It will be the integer data type. Okay, suppose here I will add one more array here. So you have to see here the change. It will be a 3 into 3. Why? Because it is having 3 rows and 3 columns. The number of dimension will be a 2. Just here, nd dimension. And the size will be a 9. Suppose here. Okay, so it will be the simply a representation of the array by using NumPy module. Here we are using 1, 2 and 3 operations, that is one is size, shape and n dimension. Actually, this function, that is n dimension function, will be a not compulsory. Why? Because we know that we are having a two axis. One is a x and other is a y. Most of the time we are using only these two. So it will be a return 2. So this program will be a simply a representation of array in the different performing with the different operations. Shape, size, nd array. And here we are finding the type of that array. Okay, so next we will see the how to create array creation. Array creation, we are having all the operation that we are see here. For array creation, you have to see here. First, I am importing NumPy as a np. After that, simply I am creating array that like 1, 2, 4 and 5, 8, 7 like that. Here I am using one more data type is equal to float. Data type is equal to float means what? Suppose here we are performing some of the operations. So for that, the suppose value will be in the floating point. So it will be not displaying that value. It will be written as an error. So for that, data type is equal to float. After that, I will be just simply print this array here. After that, okay, after that here, creating array from tuple means what? This will be a array, that is here will be a two array will be there, but what I should do here, I will create array from tuple means I will be convert the, I will take here one tuple, that is b is equal to np dot array. Here I am representing tuple in the, by using the circular bracket, that is 1, 2 and 3. After that, that the tuple that created that will be a display here. Here I am creating the 2 into 4 array with all zeros. Means what? 2 into 4 arrow. Array means what? So here just you have to see here. 2 into 3 into 4 means what? We are having 3 rows and 4 columns. 3 into 4. Here, suppose I am changing value 2 into 4. So it will be represent like a 2 rows and the value which is present in that row is a 4. Means this line will be of this line of code will be for the representation of the is the metric representation of our array. Then next, here create a constant variable for array for a complex type. Suppose we are using a complex number in our program. So for that, here we are using np.full of the array. Means the array will be into a 3×3, 6. The data type is a complex. Means the value for complex number. We are representation here like a floating for this program. This point for, this array for a float number. Like that, we are using this for the complex number. After that, we are performing one of the operation that is random value. Means what? We want to find the random value that from the that array. So for that, we are writing that np.random.random of 2×2. Suppose here, you have to see here the result for this function. Okay, so it will be a random number. Means what? We are not means the random number you have to see here, 0. Why it will be start from the 0? Because here at initial stage we are representing 3×4 array with the star with all zeros. Okay, so it will be returned at 0.10, 0.67, 0.01, 0.2. Like that. So it will be the random function. After that, here I am using a range. For that we are providing the different parameters for a range. Here we are performing that is a range operation. Here we are performing a start and nth value, and here we are having total 0 to 13 with the step of 5. So you have to see here start from the 0, the end with the 13th, and step 5 means what? We are having each point of view we are having 5 elements. So you have to see here the output. You have to see here the value which is which is display in the difference of 5 means 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Up to which I am providing here range 30. Suppose here I am providing 100. So you have to see here the output that will be a display the value start from 0 to 100 with the difference of 5. With the difference of 5. This operation, that is a range operation, is with here we are providing start value, end value, and the difference. Suppose here we are providing, suppose difference is a 3. So it will be a display all the value which is start from 0 to 100 with the difference of 3. With the difference of 3. So that function is a range function will be the. We are providing some of the specific value. Okay. So next will be create a sequence of 10 values in the range 0 to 5. Means what? The line space. Means what? We are providing line space. The operation that like we are displaying the value with the specific a gap. Like that you have to see here. The sequence array of 10 values between a 0 to 5. Sequence value. Here you have to see your first value start with the 0, then 0.5, 1, 1.1, after that 1.6, then 2.2. Means what? Here also we are up the value which will be here printed, that will be in the some space, that is a line space, which will be the like 0.5. We call it as a 0.5. You have to see here the difference of the value is a 0.5 difference. Like we called it as a 1.5 or 0.5, the difference between the representation of value of 0.5, the line space function. After that, reshaping a array means what? You have to see here. Okay, reshaping means what? Here you have to see here my array matrix is having 3 rows and 4 columns. Okay, so I want to reshape that. into a new shape, that is here two and three format. Means what? Here you have to see here, first my original array will be like this, is a three rows and four columns, and after reshaping it will be in the format of 2 2 2 2. Means what? Here we are providing 2 2 and 3. Means what? We are representing this array, means 3 into 4 array, in the format of 2 into 3. Means what? Like it will be represent the value like 1, 2, 3. Means first it will be take first 3 value, after that 4, 5, 2, and after that 4, 2, 1, and after that 2, 0, 1. Means what? My array will be reshaped with this format. And after that my original array, I will display here my original array. My original array will be what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the pattern, flat pattern array means what? Here you have to see here that 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. The my original array, and after changing array means what? We are converting my array, means it will be a two rows and three columns. It will be represent in the a single row and single column. Okay, it will be a F pattern array. So these all will be a different operations, like many operations we are performing, that like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, then 8 and 9, total 9 operation we are performing on the array, that is reshape of array, then line spacing, arranging, random, full, zero, array, like that all. So this all totally will be depend on this all point, that is a array. We are having different operation, means we are like performing the operation of concatenation, the representation of array in matrix format. We are reshaping that matrix. Then we are here using arrange function to display the values in the some specific difference that we are the difference value we are providing in our program. Then after that line spacing means what? We are displaying the floating point number in the format of 0.5 or 0.6, 0.7, like that. After that we are reshaping our array in the different format. And we are having a flatten array, means what? We are representing our original array in the a single row and single column format. This all related to the creation of array, means we are presenting our array in the different format. For that we are having total 9 operations for only creation of array in the different format. So any doubt is there regarding the creation of array? Roll number 18. Okay, any doubt? You have to perform the just this basic all operations regarding creation of array. Total 9 operations are there. You have to perform this 9 operation. Okay, so we will move to the next operation. That is a basic operations. We can use the overloading arithmetic operations to eliminate wise operations that are array to create a new array in case of the following operations. That is, we are having two basic operations, that is unary operation and binary operation. Many unary operations are provided as a methods of ND array class. That ND array means what? We are creating the array and we are performing different methods, or we are using different classes to perform the operations. In this unary operation, we are performing the some of the operation like sum, summation, minimum, maximization, like that all operation. This function can also be applied row wise or column wise setting on the accessories. Means what? We are using the function summation, minimum value, find the minimum value of that array or the maximum value of that array. So for we are performing that operation in the row wise or column wise. Okay, the unary operation. Okay, so the unary operation you have to see here. Here I am displaying one array that will be having a three rows and three columns. Okay, so first for finding the maximum element in array, for that we are using the max function. So here you have to see here array dot max function. So it will be return the maximum value that will be present in my array. So after that, here the next I want to find the maximum value row wise. For that I am using here, I am providing access is equal to 1. Why? Because I want to find for only single for the single row. So for that here I am providing the access is equal to 1. Okay, then for minimum, for finding the minimum value, we are having a same, just we are changing the max function to min function. Small element is the min function. So you have to see here the difference. First, what I should do? Print my array. Okay, so you have to see here the output. First, here I am displaying original array. After that, I want to find the large element. So it will be by using max function, we are finding the largest element in our array. So 9 will be a largest element in my array. After that, I want to find the maximum, means a largest element from the row. So you have to see here, it will be a 6, 7 and 9. In the first row, you have to see here, it will be a 6. And in second row, 7 will be the maximum. And in last row, 9 will be the maximum element. After that, the small element in the whole array will be the 1. Okay, it will be return the 1. And same row wise, in first row 1 will be there, in second row 2 will be there, and in last row 1 will be there. So it will be represent like 1, 1 and 2. Okay, so after that I will be find the summation of all the elements. So 1 plus 5 plus 6, then 4 plus 7 plus 2, 3 plus 1 plus 9, the total summation of my array element will be a 38. And after that, you have to see here the cumulative sum. Means what? We are doing the addition in the row wise. You have to see here the last element, that is, it will be the addition of this row. After that, 13 will be addition of second row, and the other 13 will be the addition of the last row. Okay, so it will be the simple unary operation, that is, we are finding the maximum, minimum and the summation of the array. It will be the unary operator. Next, we will see the binary operation. The binary operations means what? We are we are applying the array element wise, and new array is created. You can create the means binary operation. We are performing the arithmetic operations, and we are modifying some of the elements, logical elements. So you have to see here the program. Here I am displaying two arrays here. Why? Because arithmetic operations means what? We are performing multiplication, division, addition, subtraction like that. So here in first row I am arranging a matrix 2 into 2, and second also I am using a matrix 2 into 2. Okay, so here firstly I am performing the addition of array. So simply I am writing A plus B means what? It will be perform the addition operation, that is array 1 means this array and this array. And after that here I am using other function for multiplication. Okay, so you have to see here the first a summation of the array. Like you have to see here 2. The addition of summation of first array will be a 5, 5. It will be the array addition in multiplication. We are using one more function, that is a by using the dot operator. Means what? The dot operator means what? It will be a represent as a one of the multiplication. Means what? We are doing the matrix multiplication. So it will be represent the other array, that is 8, 5, 20 and 30.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, dot operation is there.
Okay. A dot operation means what? It will be a same like a multiplication. It will be the same like a multiplication, dot operator. And it will be a, we call it as a, it will be the multi, it will be the matrix multiplication. Means what? We are having here two arrays. One is A and other is a B. So A dot. The dot symbol is a difference, and we are writing the keyword, dot keyword of B. Means what? We are performing the multiplication operation here. Means what? It will be represent the matrix multiplication. So the output of this matrix multiplication will be a 8, 5 and 20 and 30. Means what? After performing the the operation on these two array, means these two array, it will be a generate one the matrix which is our result of matrix multiplication, that is 8, 5, 20 and 30. You have to perform this matrix means operation. So the dot will be the binary operation. We have to perform the subtraction also, division also, say like this only. Just you have to change the symbol. Okay, so it will be the binary operator. In the unary operation, we are finding the minimum maximum function, and we are using the sum function. And in binary operation, we are using the all the arithmetic function to perform the operation on array. Here I will write one program where I am combining both the operation, that is unary operation and binary operation in the single program. Okay, so any doubt is there regarding this operation, binary and unary operation? Okay, so any doubt is there? Those who have to execute program on the IDLE platform, they have to just open the command prompt, and you have to, if the NumPy package will be not accepting, it will be a returning error. You have to just install the NumPy, pip install NumPy. You have to install that package. It will be a work. Just only pip install NumPy. Okay. So all of you understood the NumPy. That is, we are performing the array, the operation, different operation related to array matrix. In that, we are seeing the different, like a slicing, indexing operation, and we are performing the unary and binary operations. In unary operation, we are finding the minimum, maximum, and sum function. And in binary, we are performing the arithmetic operations. Okay? Any doubt? Don't put your presentee on chat. I already take your presentee. So in next lecture, we will see the point, that is a shallow copy and deep copy. And after that, we are seeing the mathematics function. That mathematics function that we all are know that in second chapter we are covering that. That is the functions, that is minimum, maximum, root, how to find the square root, how to find the power of any number, like that. And the after that, pseudo code generation. And after that, the main point of this chapter will be the operation related to CSV files, means how to access the CSV file. The different operation, that is reading, writing, how to create, how to upload, like all the operations. Okay, so today we will stop here. If any doubt, then ask.